Joining us now at our CBN News studios in Brussels is Israeli Ambassador to the European Union and NATO, Ambassador David Waltzer. Thanks for joining us.
Good afternoon. Thanks for having me.
Many Americans watch the news. They see clearly how dangerous and untrustworthy Iran is. And yet this administration seems determined to get some sort of deal with Iran no matter what. What is going on? Does this puzzle you? It must alarm you.
Yes, I think that the second is the correct one. Yeah. It does not puzzle me. It alarms us.
But do you wonder if the Americans are just stupid? What is at play here? Why make a deal with a country that has such a bad track record?
No, I don't think the Americans are stupid. I think that if you look at our region, the broader region, the wider Middle East, leaders, by and large, in the international community, tend to deal or tend to put down fires, put out fires which are burning our fingers, and not deal with what's important, but with what is burning. And the notion that Iran can be or might be or should be a partner for us, the international community, I mean, in solving problems in the region, and therefore we better strike a deal with it, I think this is a big mistake. This is a historical, it was proven that Iran cannot be trusted. If you look at Iran's proxies in the region, all the way from Hezbollah in Lebanon, to the Shiites in Iraq, to the Houthis in Yemen, to what's going on in Syria, you can understand that a nuclear Iran, or Iran after a deal, Iran which will be equipped with much more money to support its struggle for dominance in the region, is a much more problematic, a much more dangerous player in the region. And still, the international community is trying to reach this deal. Some have even said, so what? Either we strike a deal or we go to war with Iran. I'm sorry, but those are not the only options. The international community has proven that tough sanctions do work, and Iran has come to the table. So why not go on using the measure you have been implementing successfully? Why give up? Why say Israel did not bring up any alternative to war? Yes, there is an alternative to war. We should not exclude the option of a military option. All options should be on the table. But we certainly don't limit ourselves to either war or a deal. There are other issues, there are other measures, and we are too quick to put those aside. And this is worrying, not just for Israel, for the entire Middle East. If you look at Saudi Arabia, if you look at Kuwait, if you look at Egypt or Morocco or Tunisia or Turkey, they are all much more frightened and worried than Israel is. So all those are America's, are Germany's, are the EU's partners in the region. And we keep telling you, all of you, this is a bad deal. Don't strike it.
Many American supporters of Israel have been shocked at President Barack Obama's hostility toward the current Israeli government. How would you characterize relations between the Obama White House and Prime Minister Netanyahu's government?
Well, I don't think that hostility reflects the relations between the Obama administration and Israel, and the Israeli government and Israel. We have excellent relations. We have very extensive security cooperation. We have American backing in international fora. We have disagreements. And disagreements on some fundamental and basic issues, but those occur in the most intimate companies of even within families. So hostility, I don't think, reflects the reality of our relations. I think that Israel and the United States, or should I say, the United States and Israel are very close allies and very good friends. And those disagreements, they have happened in the past. We had crises. We overgrew those and we managed to overcome and develop our relations even farther. But I don't think that hostility reflects the relations or the wind blowing from the White House towards Israel.
Would you say that relations could be better?
Relations can always be improved. And yes, relations can be better. Yeah. I hope to minimize our disagreements and misunderstandings, but hostility, I'm sorry, does not reflect the mood.
Are you surprised that we're again dealing with anti-Semitism in Europe?
I'm not sure whether I'm surprised, but I hoped very much that 70 years after the Holocaust, anti-Semitism will definitely or will never be on the rise again in Europe. And the fact that we are talking about it today, and the fact that Jews in this continent ask themselves whether they should stay here or leave, by itself is frightening. And again, here it's a mixture of anti-Semitism, old classical anti-Semitism, and xenophobia, and hatred of the other, and hatred of minorities, and all that is frightening. And the fact that it is happening in Europe in the year 2015, as I said, only 70 years after the Holocaust, is indeed frightening.
Is the time of the Jews, as some suggest, is the time of the Jews in Europe over?
I hope very much not. Look, we have created the State of Israel as a safe haven for Jews, for every Jew who feels that he is threatened and wishes to come to Israel. Israel is open to receive everyone. The decision is the decision of the family, the decision of the person, the decision of the communities. I don't think their time in Europe is over. I think that the threat is growing and the dangers are much bigger than they used to be. By the end of the day, it should be the decision of every person whether he wants to pack and leave for Israel or for the States or for anywhere in the world. I think that the fact that people ask themselves this question is by itself frightening. Mind you, Jews have lived in this continent for thousands of years. The fact that they have to ask themselves whether it is still their home is by itself frightening.
I can't help but ask, is there a feeling that in Israel that you're losing friends in the world, that the number of nations you can count on continues to shrink?
To a degree, we have excellent bilateral relations with many countries in the world. But yes, it is worrying. We would like to be, if you wish, more popular, but we will stay the course. Mm-hmm. We know that we fight for something which is just, and we will stay the course until we have a solid partner, I think, to discuss the fate of the region with and to strike a political deal. Until then, in direct negotiations with this partner, among a Palestinian partner, of course, until then, we will stay the course because it's the just one and we are right.
Well, I know our many CBN viewers that support Israel are praying for Israel
thank
and standing
so
with it. Ambassador David Walzer, thank you for joining us.
Again, thanks for having me.